Now we come to second, we are going to start our next classes, and we have so far discussed continuity and change, characteristic of Indian culture. We are discussing yesterday, and we have discussed ancient origin, what are the characteristic of Indian culture. And we have discussed ancient origin, and we have discussed also continuity and change. And next we are going to discuss third point, variety and unity. And you will see in Indian culture you will find variety and unity also. Few cultures in the world could boast of such variety as the Indian culture. There is so much variety you will find. Indian culture over the last 3 millennia has assimilated the best part from other religions and cultures and integrated them into itself. India is home to many religions of the world, like Hinduism you will find, the adherents of Jainism you will find residing in India, Buddhism, Sikhism, numerous styles of architecture, sculpture, and painting, music, and dances. All these forms you will find. Our literature in different languages also reflect this composite nature. Our culture is a very composite in nature. Ganga Yamuna Sanskriti, you may call. Since time immemorial, people from far and near have been coming and settling here. Muslims came and settled here. Sak and Kushans came and settled here. Greek, Yunani, all came here and settled in India. And now, why is there so much variety in our culture? There are many reasons for this. There are many reasons why these varieties are. The vastness of the country, all we have discussed yesterday also, some of the points, and variation in its physical and climate features is an obvious reason for this variety. What is the reason for this variety? This is a very important point, very important point. If someone asks you, what is the variety for so many varieties in India? The answer will be physical and climate features. If you go in south, climatic conditions are different, in north different. And from those, and by those climatic features, there is a difference of clothes, of food habits. Okay. Good evening. Ayushji. The second important reason for the variety in our culture is intermingling among various ethnic groups. All we have discussed yesterday. Now, my style is that what we have left yesterday on this point, and I am starting from this point. So, all we have discussed, our country looks like a variety and diversity, but there is also a common cultural unity is there. Common cultural unity and secular outlook. Next, our feature is, and we are discussing what characteristic of Indian culture. Characteristic of Indian culture, what is the features, what is the characteristic, secular outlook. And nowadays this topic is very important. This topic is very important for essay point of view also. secular character of Indian culture is a result of the what? Result of intermingling of people belonging to diverse cultural groups over a long period of time. You cannot assume that if some regime, suppose that you cannot say that if some regime try to dismantle this secular outlook, it cannot be successful. Why? It cannot be successful. Why? Suppose that a ruling party tries to dismantle the secular outlook of India. And would it be successful? No. Why? Because a long period of time, diverse cultural groups settle here. So it cannot be dismantled or disruption. There cannot be a disruption in one go. So, and this understanding should be must in every mind of Indian. The popular cultural tradition of India are the best examples of such cultural synthesis. A cultural synthesis happen. Use this term, terminology, mark the terminology, mind the terminology, I am using those terminologies, in which a large number of people belonging to different religious groups come together. The state has no religion of its own. Secular outlook in constitution we have. Why? Our constitutional maker, why they adopted a secular outlook? Why they adopted? If you study closely, the nation in making during the time of British period, starting from 1857 to 1947, the foundation of Indian Congress was based on so secular outlook. And the national movement was running on this secular outlook. Our very great leaders like Gandhi, Nehru, Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, Rajendra Prasad, all were adherents of the secular outlook. So our nation making was based on the secular outlook during British period also, in modern times also, and in medieval times also, though the ruling class was though Muslims, but the majority of the people from adherents were Hindus, but there were coexistence, and this coexistence existed for a last 600 years, 700 years. So this was the background. This is the background. And all religions are treated equally by the state. The people believe in the concept of leave and let others leave. Most important thing is that leave and let others leave. In India, people generally the concept is leave and let others leave. It cannot. This sentence is also a good example of a topic of essay. It can be. Leave and let others leave. This is our secular outlook. And next we come to universalism. What is universalism? The concept of coexistence has not been confined to the geographical and political boundaries of the country. Universalism means what? Coexistence is not confined to geographical political boundaries of the country. India has a universal outlook. See the example of Vivekananda. India has a universal outlook. And it has been promoting the message of peace and harmony to the entire world. See the 1893 Chicago Dharma Sammelan. It was, and in Vivekananda, what he said? He said about the peace and harmony of the, he He presented the Hindu religion. And Hindu religion of what? He said that in Chicago, that he had came from a country which had advocated peace and harmony, which had been place of all the religions. He said, so India has been raising a strong voice against racialism and colonialism. It is protected against the formation of power blocks in the world during the Cold War. So our appeal is what? Universalism. And even you will find in Corona period also, you will find we have sent medical equipments, we have sent medicines in foreign countries also, in USA also. So our appeal is that in culture we have adopted, inherent in our blood universalism is there. In every Indian you will find universal appeal. In every Indian, materialistic and spiritualistic. Next we come to materialistic and spiritualistic. We are both at the same time. Generally people say that in the East, East means India, Indian people are very spiritualistic. But we are materialistic as well as spiritualistic both. India is popularly known to be a land of spirituality, particularly to the West. Generally, the people of the West considers Indians what? A land of spirituality. A land of spirituality. However, Indian history from ancient times to present day shows that the development of materialistic and non-materialistic culture have been going on alongside. And see the example of Harappan civilization was an urban one. We have both features, materialistic and spiritualistic. The Harappan people were materialistic people. So if you are going to discuss Harappan people, suppose that, Harappan civilization, suppose that, you will mention what word? Materialistic. The Harappan civilization, the people of Harappan civilization were materialistic. Because they founded a great city in which all of the, see the urban infrastructure, what kind of urban infrastructure was there? Very superb infrastructure was there. In modern day, only Chandigarh and organized urban localities can compare with the grid pattern of Harappan civilization city pattern. It had a systematic town plan. See this, a question has been asked in UPSC also. A question has been asked from this section. Though the exact section will be Harappan civilization, when we discuss Harappan civilization, we will discuss in great detail. We will discuss in great detail the town planning of Harappan civilization. A question has been asked in 2017. Okay, 2017, I suppose, or 18. 2018, 17 and 18, a question has been asked on the systematic town planning. And the question was there in that form that what we have input from town planning of Harappan civilization in modern day, in modern times, an elaborate drainage system, an elaborate drainage system. And they had a profound knowledge of mathematics, weights and measures, discoveries of theory like earth revolves around the sun, earth is round, were made by Indians long before Europe accepted them. Aryabhatta was there. Aryabhatta was there. So you should bear in the mind that we are materialistic right from beginning. We are materialistic right from beginning. Yes, yes, yes. Shreyas, it is beneficial for BPSC also. It is beneficial for BPSC also. Shreyas is from my student of an academy. That's why I teach only in Hindi medium. In Hindi medium. Yes, Shreyas, you can do it. It is beneficial. Because we will discuss art and culture in the ancient of and medieval times. So it will be beneficial for UPSC also. We will discuss Pal art, Maurya art, all will be featured in the first paper. Okay. So take class regularly, Shreyas. There was no opposition or resistance by religious or other thoughts in pursuing such knowledge. So, we are materialistic and spiritualistic also, inclusiveness and coexistence was also there. Indian culture has included different elements of other cultures that came in contact. It is the reason why it has impacted the Arab and European culture. Indian culture has included different elements of other cultures. Suppose that a question can be asked. In every sentence, you will find a question from. Your mind should be broadened. Enough broadened to more and more thought making process should be there in your mind. Questions. In every paragraph, there will be a question. Otherwise, after then, your interest will be there. Feel the history, feel the essence of history. Otherwise, it will be easy for understanding. The remembering would not be a mere part of cramming. So, Indian culture has included, suppose that a question has been asked. In inverted comma, suppose that. Indian culture has included different elements of other cultures that it came in contact. In that way, discuss it, prove it, consider it. It is the reason why it has impacted Arab and European culture also. This cultural amalgamation, see the term, is a continuous process and it is going on till date. Till date, many features of the other cultures we are adopting, and in turn we are giving some effects on other cultures also. See this sucks. Huns, Kushanas, Arabs, Turks, Parsis kept coming to the country and it enriched this culture. As per Dr. Radhakrishnan, our revered President of India, is the only country where there is peaceful coexistence between temples, churches, gurdwaras and mosques. In India you will find. See the example of USA. USA boasts of what? Advanced country, but see the what incidents are going on. Apartheid. A division between blacks and whites. Many of the human rights violations against the blacks. You will see in last 2 days ago, a similar incident was there. Racial apartheid. So, and in India, though there are examples in India also, but more or less, peaceful coexistence is there. Now, it comes to cultural identity, religion and regionalism. Our cultural identity is based on various aspects such as religion, domicile. It depends on political, social and economic factors. We are discussing a very important topic. Very important topic. This topic is also related to Indian society. Indian society, social issues, ethics, essay. It is beneficial for paper 1 and other papers also. And cultural identity. So, our cultural identity depends on what? Political, social and economic factors also. So, you cannot assume that this is very great thing. we are discussing very great thing. Cultural identity based on political, social and economic factors. Suppose that cultural identity and make a chart. In GS paper 1, 2, 3, 4, make a chart. Cultural identity, suppose that. And show this political, social, economic factors. Present them in a flow chart. For example, see this. Muslim cultures of Uttar Pradesh differ significantly with that of Kerala. It means religion and regionalism is there. Coexistence with nature. Next we come to next point, coexistence with nature. See this, how this topic is very important right now. Right now, coexistence with nature, right now. We are going a very difficult time. We are going through very difficult time. Is it right? Coexistence with nature, Ayush. Coexistence with nature is a salient feature of our Indian culture, is salient feature of characteristic of Indian culture. Coexistence with nature. Am I right? Are you getting my word? Are you getting my word? Is it right? Bilkul. Coexistence with nature. Coexistence with nature. Oh, Atul Kashyap is also there. Okay. So, Indian culture is deeply associated with nature. It is also a very important topic for essay point of view. Coexistence with nature. We are discussing in characteristic of Indian culture. So, understand this point. Philosophy, Indian literature and Vedas were compiled in the vicinity of forest and nature. A love toward nature, a protection of nature, you will find in every Indian literature, in philosophy, in Vedas, in thoughts of our great leaders, even Gandhi's. Gandhi. For example, Atharvaveda considers the earth to be our mother. Considers the earth to be mother. These values have gained importance recently in form of conservation effort towards environment. Nowadays, environment is very hot topic. Even pandemic is, some scientists are relating pandemic to deterioration of environment also, global warming also. It means we have to protect environment, respecting nature and conserving natural heritage. We will discuss the heritage in great detail. It is enshrined in Indian philosophy inside. हाँ बिल्कुल 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 तुलसी की है, आंवले की है, बहुत सारी चीजों की है. पीपल को पेड़ नहीं उखाड़ना है. बिल्कुल है, एकदम बिल्कुल सही बात है. और अभी तो आप काढ़ा देख रहे हो, तुलसी का काढ़ा. व्हाट इज दिस? गिलोई के पेड़, अभी तो सभी चीजों का वो है. आपको तो आश्चर्य की बात यह है कि मैं इस कोरोना काल में मैंने, है ना, आई स्पेंट 300 रुपीज फॉर परचेजिंग ए गिलोई प्लांट. वो मैंने वो, और नर्सरियों में भीड़ बढ़ गई है लोगों की. नर्सरियों में भीड़ बढ़ गई और मेरा हृदय एक दिन बड़ा द्रवित हो गया देख करके कि भाई नर्सरी में मैं गया था, वहां पे एक पुलिस इंस्पेक्टर साहब बेचारे मास्क पहन के, मास्क लगा करके और तुलसी के पौधे को दोनों हाथों से पकड़ के ले जा रहे थे पुलिस ड्रेस में। पुलिस ड्रेस में बगल में नर्सरी है, बगल में थाना है, थाना से निकल के आए और तुलसी के पौधे लेके जा रहे। व्हाट इज दिस, व्हाट इज दिस? सो नाउ इट इज ऑल्सो केयरिंग विद द नेचर, लव विद द नेचर। In this pandemic period, we are discussing, my notes is prepared long ago, this pandemic. But see this, coexistence with nature. Major religions such as Hinduism, Buddhism and Jainism, you will find in many tribal group, tribal peoples who worship plants, who worship plants. They all preach non-violence of conservation environment. So it is inherent in our, and India can boast, India can set example, India can give a torchlight bearer. India capacity is the torchlight bearer. The whole world, what we have in Atharvaveda or our historical books and philosophies, protection towards environment is already there long before it, the discussions on environment began on the world stage. Before that period, we have in our literature, our philosophy, coexistence with the principle of coexistence with nature was there. हाँ बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, उसको भी ये पूजा है। गंगा आरती क्या है, वटी से गंगा आरती, नदियों की पूजा है, कुओं की पूजा होती है ना भाई, कुओं की पूजा होती है। तो ये सब चीजें हैं वो, तो ये सब चीजें वही तो है। तो इसका मतलब क्या है, किसी भी चीज को स्टडी आप करो, पढ़ो, फील करो उसको, कहीं याद करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़े, जो कहीं भी कोई चीज आ जाए इन सब चीजों को यूज करके लिख दो। जो आजकल के बच्चे जो है वो 22 साल में 23 साल में वो सब रिजल्ट ला रहे हैं, इसलिए ला रहे हैं कि बस बी रेगुलर, क्लासेस शुड बी रेगुलर और सोचिए ज्यादा, माइंड एक्सरसाइज बहुत ज्यादा कीजिए। जितना सोचिएगा जितना ही आपकी, और रिटन प्रैक्टिस शुड बी देयर। वी आर कमिंग विथ अ न्यू फॉर्मेट ऑन, वी हैव डेवलप्ड ए ऐप आल्सो, एंड मोबिशाला ऐप, यू विल फाइंड आंसर राइटिंग क्लासेज आल्सो देयर। सो आंसर राइटिंग आप लिख करके भेजोगे उस ऐप पे और मैं उसको टेस्ट करके, जिस तरह से मैं पेन से लिख रहा हूँ ना, ऐसे मैं जांच के आपको भेज दूंगा घर बैठे, कहीं बाहर निकलने की जरूरत नहीं है। ये ऑनलाइन क्लासेज जो है बहुत अच्छा है, बहुत अच्छी चीज है, इट इज वेरी नाइस थिंग, आई अप्रिशिएट दिस, कि घर बैठे हुए आप एकदम बैठ करके आप मजे से पढ़ रहे हैं, ना आने की झंझट, ना जाने की झंझट। तो बहुत अच्छी चीज है, बहुत अच्छी चीज है। अब वी आर नाउ कमिंग टू हेरिटेज, हेरिटेज एंड इंट्रोडक्शन। और ये आप पाओगे कि हेरिटेज जो है वो एक वर्ड है, हम लोग इसको डिस्कस करने जा रहे हैं, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हेरिटेज, बिकॉज इन द मेंस पेपर यू विल फाइंड द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ दिस वर्ड, आर्ट एंड कल्चर एंड हेरिटेज। आर्ट एंड कल्चर एंड हेरिटेज इज मेंशन in UPSC's main syllabus. So first we should discuss the appropriate word. First we should define, try to gain what is the meaning of heritage. Why the UPSC has mentioned heritage in GS paper 1? First we will discuss concept of heritage. What is this? Heritage means I have shown in that formula. This is the formula. Inheritance plus past. Heritage means, remember it. Inheritance from what? Inheritance from past. It is called heritage. Okay? Heritage refers. It is very interesting topic. Very interesting topic. Heritage refers to something inherited from past. This past can be geological past, historical past. Heritage as a word has several connotations. This word denotes some perceptions prevalent in different countries and cultures, as well as notions and realities. The heritage word has several different senses. First, we are discussing natural heritage. What is natural heritage? See this. You will be amazed. You will be amazed to hear that we are going to discuss geography and environment in culture. Geography and environment in culture we are going to discuss. It is amazing. It is amazing. So, what is natural heritage? An inheritance of flora and fauna, geology, landscape, landforms, and other natural resources. Generally, in classes of art and culture, all this topic is generally not discussed. Generally not discussed. But my style is something different from other styles. Because, so, this is the natural heritage. Heritage means inheritance from past. We have variety. We have variety of mangoes. मैंगो आप खाते हो ना भाई, मैंगो खाते हो तो मैंगो क्या है? इनहेरिटेंस तो है. फील करिए, फील करो. इतिहास को रटो मत, मत रटो, मत रटो. ये मैंगो क्या है? अगर हमारे पूर्वजों ने इफ दे हैड नॉट प्रोटेक्टेड दिस वैरायटी, इट वुड नॉट बी पॉसिबल टू. कैसे हमने पाया? परंपरा से चली आ रही. तो कहने का मतलब यह है कि ये फ्लोरा फौना एंड यू विल फाइंड इन एनवायरनमेंट, एनवायरनमेंट प्रोटेक्शन लॉज आर देयर. एम आई राइट? आर यू गेटिंग माई वर्ड? देयर आर एनवायरनमेंट प्रोटेक्शन लॉज फॉर व्हाट? फॉर प्रोटेक्टिंग नेचुरल हेरिटेज. Your duty is to protect natural heritage. Your duty is. So that's why UPSC has included all this topic. Suppose that you will be in future, you are going to be IAS officer. And you are on the chair of policy making, of culture. You are Secretary of Culture and Environment Minister. What is your duty? What is your duty? So flora and fauna, geology, landscape. It means what? It means mountains, plateaus, our river systems. All these are to be protected. All these are to be protected compulsorily. Compulsorily. And landforms, other natural resources. We have many natural resources. What are the natural resources? Next, we come to cultural heritage, the legacy of physical artifacts, intangible attributes of a group or society, man-made heritage. So, cultural heritage means physical artifacts. Suppose that Taj Mahal, all these are cultural heritage, inheritance from past. Heritage means inheritance from past. But we have inherited good things from past are called heritage. intangible attributes also. Tangible and intangible market. We will discuss in great detail cultural later. And see this food habit. Food habit. Food habit means it is also a cultural heritage. Sorry, food heritage comes falls into and we have discussed the litti chokha yesterday. We have discussed that. Poha, jalebi, all we have discussed. Pav bhaji from Maharashtra, biryani from Hyderabad. Ayush, are you getting my word? Yesterday we have all discussed. तो भाई हाँ बिल्कुल हैदराबाद बिरयानी फेमस है, बिरयानी फेमस है जो है तो है ना. तो ये क्या है, फूड हेरिटेज है, फूड हेरिटेज है. हेरिटेज के लिए कई सब ये है, हम लोग तो सोचते नहीं है. आर्ट एंड कल्चर के वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक, वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक. आपको तो बोरियत ही नहीं होगी अगर आप सोचेंगे ध्यान से क्या है क्या नहीं है. तो इट इज फूड हेरिटेज. आपकी आपके आपकी मम्मी ने आपको सिखाया भाई अचार बनाने का तरीका, तो वो क्या है, वो पीढ़ी दर पीढ़ी चली जाती है. वी गॉट दोज ट्रेट्स ऑफ फूड हेरिटेज फ्रॉम आवर मदर्स. तो हम लोग वो सीखते हैं ना, और वो नहीं जो सीखता है तो फिर वो कई सारी चीजें छूट जाती हैं, अगली पीढ़ी को ट्रांसफर नहीं होती. हाँ बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, अरे वो तो है कहवा बिल्कुल 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 बिल्कुल. रमेश तिवारी ऑल्सो देयर, वेरी वेरी नाइस वेरी नाइस. तो ये क्या है, ये जो है वो फूड हेरिटेज है. इतिहास तो जो है वो बिल्कुल इंटरेस्टिंग चीजें हैं वो, कि भाई हमने कभी गंभीरता से उसको सोचा ही नहीं जो है वो. मोदी जी के यहाँ कोई बाहरी मेहमान आता है, अभी तो कोरोना का टाइम है, तो लजीज वो सब चीजों का टेस्ट करवाते हैं कि भाई ये देखो गुजरात का ये क्या है, वो महाराष्ट्र का क्या है ना. तो दिस फॉल्स इंटू फूड हेरिटेज, इंडस्ट्रियल हेरिटेज, मोन्यूमेंट्स फ्रॉम इंडस्ट्रियल कल्चर, वर्चुअल हेरिटेज, वर्क डीलिंग विथ कल्चरल हेरिटेज, एंड इन इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ व्हाट, फिजिकल एंड नॉन फिजिकल. देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस. सपोज दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी फाइन थिंग. सपोज दैट ये ईश्वर की इच्छा ना हो कि भाई मान लीजिए कि आपके है ना घर में जो है आपके फादर का डेथ होता है. कल्पना करिए व्हाट वी गेट इनहेरिटेंस, फिजिकल फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी, फिजिकल इसीलिए मैंने पहले कह दिया फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी यू विल गेट फ्रॉम इनहेरिटेंस, बट यू विल ऑल्सो गेट नॉन फिजिकल इनहेरिटेंस ऑल्सो, एंड विच इज ए बिग डील, which is great, physical inheritance or non-physical inheritance. I am going to ask you, what will be a big deal, what is bigger than non-physical or physical, non-physical or physical. You are going to get a property, but you are also at the same time you are going to get non-physical इनहेरिटेंस. वट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू, बोलिए आयुष जी बोलिए, कौन बड़ा है महत्वपूर्ण है. सोचने पे मैं विवश कर दूंगा आप, सोचने पे विवश कर दूंगा कि आपको पूरा याद हो जाए. यस एग्जैक्टली राइट, आई वॉन्टेड दिस क्वेश्चन, वेल डन. आई वॉन्टेड दिस क्वेश्चन आंसर, स्मार्ट आंसर, स्मार्ट आंसर. मैं तो यही चाहता था कि भाई वो फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी कोई वैल्यू नहीं है उसकी, आप भी कमा लोगे इफ यू गेट अ 1 करोड़ रुपीज ऑफ बिल्डिंग, आप कमा लोगे उतना पैसा, कोई बहुत बड़ी बात नहीं है। लेकिन पिताजी ने आपको क्या शिक्षा दी है? बाबू ईमानदार रहना, बाबू जहां नौकरी करना ईमानदारी से करना, गरीबों का ध्यान रखना, गैर कानूनी काम मत करो, ये आपके पिताजी ने सिखाया था। सिखाया था कि नहीं सिखाया था? सो इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ नॉन फिजिकल इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट, इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम फिजिकल। इफ यू कंपेयर विद द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी कैन बी अगेन गेन्ड, बट नॉन फिजिकल एसेट्स व्हाट वी गेट फ्रॉम आवर फादर्स आवर मदर्स इनहेरिटेंस गोज इन आवर नेक्स्ट जनरेशन। सो इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ फिजिकल गुड्स आफ्टर द डेथ ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल ऑफ द फिजिकल और नॉन फिजिकल थिंग्स इनहेरिटेड, ये तो लाइनें कई जगह लिखी रहती हैं, लेकिन सेट द एग्जाम्पल, सोचो जरा, विवश करो सोचने पे, तब जाकर के चीजें आपको याद हो जाएंगी, उस पर गंभीरता से बहस होगी, कभी नहीं आपको जो है वो भूलेगा। हेरिडिटरी बायोलॉजिकल इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ फिजिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक बर्थराइट, तो ये सब ऑल दीज आर थिंग्स। नाउ नाउ we come to next topic, natural heritage. We will discuss in more points. Refer to the sum total of elements of biodiversity, including flora and fauna and ecosystem types, together with associated geological structure and formations geodiversity. Natural heritage, all the, you will find sab jadi booti kya hai. If you goes to higher altitude in the mountains of Himalaya, you will find many of the herbs, very important. So we have our duty to protect this. Phoolon ki ghati, see this valley of flowers. I have visited all these places. Oli, in Chamoli district, and biosphere. Nandadevi Biosphere Reserve is there. Nandadevi Biosphere Reserve, you will find flowers of valley, valley of flowers. So natural heritage are all these are, and for that region, Biosphere Reserve are there for protecting this heritage. Natural heritage includes entire range of crystal veils. A country has belonging to different symmetries. Tricline monolithic reserves of geolites in Deccan, Akromion in Tamil Nadu, geological formations, Shivalik for its rich vertebrates, Vindhya for sandstone and limestone, and Equus Ramapithecus, Sivapithecus, all these, but natural heritage, the main point is natural heritage. Bilkul Gangotri is also. All these are heritages. Exactly right. And now, some of the major natural heritages are climate also. So we have to protect climate also, natural heritage. It is a heritage because it has a direct and indirect effect on the people of the country. On their psyche, how to think, how they respond, and how it is their cultural evolves. Climate itself, all these are the natural heritage includes what? Crystal wealth, geological formations, physiographic differences and diversities, and climate also. Now we come to last point, cultural heritage. And I suppose you have a proper understanding of a heritage. Cultural heritage is the legacy of physical artifacts and intangible attributes, a group or society that are inherited from past generations, maintained in the present and bestowed for the benefit of future generations. Cultural heritage includes what? Cultural heritage of two types. First, ये सेकंड एंड फर्स्ट. फर्स्ट इज टेंजेबल कल्चर सच एज बिल्डिंग्स, मोन्यूमेंट्स, लैंडस्केप्स, बुक्स, वर्क्स ऑफ आर्ट एंड आर्टिफैक्ट्स. एंड द इनटेंजेबल सच एज फोकलोर, ट्रेडिशंस, लैंग्वेज एंड नॉलेज. सपोज दैट कल्चरल हेरिटेज मीन्स टेंजेबल. टेंजेबल मीन्स वट यू सी, वट यू सी दैट देर इज ए ताजमहल, देर इज ए मोन्यूमेंट, कुतुब मीनार, बुक्स, वेदास, वर्क्स ऑफ आर्ट, मुगल पेंटिंग, ऑल दिस फॉल्स इन टू टेंजेबल कल्चर. इट मीन्स कल्चरल हेरिटेज, इनहेरिटेंस फ्रॉम पास. एंड इनटेंजेबल ऑफ वॉट? फोल्कलोर, ट्रेडिशंस लाइक फेस्टिवल्स, लाइक फेस्टिवल्स, लैंग्वेजेस, आवर कमांड ऑफ लैंग्वेजेस, हिंदी लैंग्वेज, तमिल, तेलुगु, ऑल आर द इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ द पास्ट. हमने कैसे सीखा भाई? हमने कैसे सीखा? हमने स्कूल में सीखा, अपने पिताजी से सीखा, माताजी से सीखा. एंड नॉलेज हमने किससे सीखा? नॉलेज भी तो पहले से सीखा. ऑल दिस फॉल्स इन टू इंटेंजेबल कल्चर. सो इट इज द एंड वी हैव ऑल दिस डिस्कस्ड. एंड नाउ वी प्रोसीड टू द नेक्स्ट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, डिफरेंस बिटवीन कल्चर एंड सिविलाइजेशन. कल्चर एंड सिविलाइजेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस. इट इज वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स टॉपिक. जनरली स्टूडेंट्स एंड कन्फ्यूज, जनरली कन्फ्यूज अबाउट दिस टॉपिक, डिफरेंसेज बिटवीन कल्चर एंड सिविलाइजेशन. बट आफ्टर डिस्कशन फ्रॉम माई क्लास यू विल बी गेट अ क्लियर पिक्चर एंड क्लियर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. Have you ever wondered why the one who is poor and is shabbily attired is regarded as uncivilized, even though he may be the most cultured person, and the one in a sophisticated outfit is called civilized, but may not be having the sense of culture? Very nice example has been given here. One who is poor and is shabbily attired is regarded as uncivilized, even though he be a most cultured person. And the one in a sophisticated outlook is called civilized, but may not be having the sense of culture. So culture is everything about the human society. It refers to the knowledge and features of a specific group of people living in a region. On the other extreme, civilization of what? Is the breakthrough of human society, meaning that it is the advanced level of social and human development. This is a very complex things, but I have made it easy for to get a broader understand. Civilization means what? A level of social and human development is called civilization. People often conflate the terms culture and civilization and end up using them synonymously. They are not synonymous word. Culture and civilization are not synonymous word. We use the term Indus Valley civilization. Why? Why we call Indus Valley civilization? Why we call Indus Valley civilization? So This is the comparison chart. This is the chart. Meaning what we meaning? Culture is a term used to denote the manifestations of the manner in which we think, behave and act. First meaning culture is a term used to denote the manifestations of the manner in which we think, behave and act. But civilization refers to the process through which a region or a society outstretches an advanced stage of human development and organization. What we have said, advanced stage of human development and organization. And why it is? It is the end, but it is the means. The basis for comparison represents what we are and what he possesses. What we possess, reflected in what? Religion, art, dance, literature, customs, morals, music, philosophy. But reflected in law, administration, infrastructure, market, architecture, social arrangements. An expression, higher level of inner refinement, higher level of general development, advancement, no, yes. Interdependency, culture can grow and exist without civilization, market. Civilization cannot grow and exist without culture. And now we will discuss on each and every point in great detail. What is the first meaning? And then we will try to summarize it. We will try to summarize it. Culture is a term to use the manifestations of manner. Think, behave, and act. It means attitudes, our behavioral pattern, our value system. All these falls into what? Culture. Our traditions also. All these four items falls into what? Exactly. All these falls into culture. जैसे हम कहते हैं ना कि भाई ये आदमी कल्चर्ड नहीं है जो है ना. कोई व्यक्ति आपसे मिलता है और मान लीजिए कि कोई व्यक्ति आता है और बिल्कुल वो तमीज से बात नहीं करता है, अच्छे से बात नहीं करता है, वो तमीज से बात नहीं करता है, तो आप कहते हो ना कि ये अनकल्चर्ड है, अनकल्चर्ड पर्सन है, कल्चर उसका कुछ नहीं है जो है. लेकिन सिविलाइजेशन, और इसको मैं आई विल गिव ए एग्जाम्पल, इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन वी कॉल. वाई? इट मीन्स हायर लेवल ऑफ डेवलपमेंट ऑफ व्हाट? रोड्स, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, सिटीज फॉर दैट रीजन, एडवांस स्टेज ऑफ रोड्स, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एंड सिटीज. That's why we call Indus Valley civilization. Clear? Are you clear? And it is the means. Civilization is the means. Culture is the end. By that means we try to get our ends. Culture ek badi cheez hai. Culture is a bigger concept. And civilization is a smaller concept. Civilization includes into culture. Civilization falls into the culture. What we are? आप क्या हो? What we possess? आपके पास क्या है? What we possess? भाई, what I possess? And what I am? तो ये बातें हैं. And see this, religion, art, dance, literature, custom, morals, music, philosophy, all these are falls into what? Culture. But law, administration, infrastructure, only this item will, if you get confused about how to make differences between culture and civilization, then only one word, if you remember that word, it will help you to find differences between culture and civilization. Culture and civilization, it will be easy for you with the help of only, I am giving you a formula. By simply that word, you easily differentiate between culture and civilization, infrastructure. and remember the infrastructure of Indus Valley civilization. By that point, it will be easy to you to differentiate between culture and civilization. Are you getting my word? Are you getting my point? Higher level of inner refinement, attitude, traditions, behavior, pattern. These are the inner refinement of a human being. But higher level of general development is reflected in infrastructure. And last point is also important. Culture can grow and exist without civilization. Suppose that in any civilization, there is no such advanced stage of infrastructure, but there can be a very good culture can be. But civilization cannot grow and exist without culture. But in any civilization, in also Indus Valley civilization, there will you will find cultural aspects also. Cultural aspects also. So, and definition of culture, all this I will provide. And all of you should contact Institute for getting notes, proper notes. You should consult proper notes. And you will be provided in through app detailed PDF if you want, and lectures plus PDFs. And so definition of culture is there, definition of civilization is there, and but chart is enough, culture and civilization, chart is enough. Though you will get definition of culture, definition of civilization separately. And suppose that I have given some questions, but I suppose it is so. If you getting the clear picture, Ayush. If you getting the clear picture, the question number second is very clear. I want to discuss it. Though the question is not asked from this section, the question is a very less and less possibility of any question from that section. So that's why I have only two questions from these sections. Suppose that we will discuss second question. Consider the following statements regarding culture. The word culture is derived from the Latin term cultus. It is a way of life which is made by ourselves. But suppose that all the achievements of human beings can be called culture. Which of the statements given above are correct? And what is the answer? This is some practice. What will be the answer? क्या आंसर होगा इसका? Consider the following statements regarding culture. The word culture is derived from the Latin term cultus, and all the achievements of human beings can be called as culture. It is a way of life which is made by ourselves. I suppose you are getting some difficulty. Question number one, consider the following statements. The picture is not so clear, but Indian culture has an enduring, it will be easy for you. First question is, Indian culture has enduring character. Indian culture has an enduring character. A remarkable feature of Indian culture is that it has not changed with time. It has not changed with time. Culture is a spiritual development of a race or a nation. Culture is made of a traditions, beliefs, way of life from the most spiritual to the most material. Which of the statements given above are correct? कौन सा होगा बोलिए. बोलिए आयुष गिव द रिप्लाई. केवल इस चैप्टर से आज चैप्टर ये खत्म हो जाएगा. ओनली आई हैव टेकन टू क्वेश्चंस. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन जो है वो कल्चर के बारे में है. कल्चर की हम लोगों ने डेफिनेशन पढ़ी है और कल्चर के कुछ ट्रेड्स भी पढ़े हैं. वी हैव स्टडीड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ कल्चर. बाय दैट सेक्शन ए क्वेश्चन हैज बीन आस्क्ड. फ्रॉम दैट सेक्शन ए कल्चर A question has been asked, and suppose that you can get this type of questions in CSAT paper also. CSAT paper में भी आप पा सकते हो ऐसे question को. आयु सभी आप class में हैं, class छोड़ चुके हैं. Are you hearing my word? इसको बनाइए, कैसे बनाइएगा? Are you facing some difficulty? तो बताइए, मैं हेल्प करूं. मैं क्वेश्चन की बहुत कराता हूं प्रैक्टिस जो है. क्वेश्चन की बहुत सारी प्रैक्टिस आगे आगे होती जाएगी सभी बच्चों को. सभी लोगों को क्वेश्चन की प्रैक्टिस होती जाएगी. तो देखिए, दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क. चलिए वो आप लोग देख लीजिएगा, इसको बनाइएगा. और ये क्लास को एंड करने के टाइम आ गया है और कल हम लोग फिर मिलते हैं. इसी टाइम पे हम लोग मिलते हैं. वो अच्छे, चलिए आ गया रिप्लाई जो है वो थोड़ी स्पीड का ये है, कोई बात नहीं है. अच्छा दिव्या, तुम लेट से क्यों आई हो? दिव्या वाई आर सो लेट? एक दो तीन आपने पहले का आंसर जो है वो आयुष आपने किसका कोई कोई नहीं, सॉरी तो नहीं होगा. देयर विल बी कंप्लेन होगा आपकी जो है. आप सबसे अनियमित हैं. आयुष इज वेरी रेगुलर. कोई बात नहीं है. देखिए मैं समझा दे रहा हूं. इसका आंसर जो है वो हमने डिस्कस किया है. इसका आंसर जो है वो बी है. फर्स्ट का बी है आंसर. फर्स्ट का बी है. बी आंसर विल बी बी. देखिए हमने आपको पढ़ाया था ना फीचर में, कैरेक्टरिस्टिक में. ए रिमार्केबल फीचर ऑफ इंडियन कल्चर इज दैट इट हैज नॉट चेंज विद टाइम. ये तो गलत है, ये तो गलत है. हमने बताया ना कि कल्चर वो टाइम से चेंज हो गया है. कल्चर की एक करेक्टरिस्टिक है, इट चेंजेज विद द टाइम. इट चेंजेज विद द टाइम. सो इट इज द रॉन्ग स्टेटमेंट. इंडियन कल्चर है इंड्यूरिंग कैरेक्टर इज ए राइट स्टेटमेंट. कल्चर इज ए स्पिरिचुअल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ए रेस और नेशन. एग्जैक्टली राइट. कल्चर इज मेड अप ऑफ ट्रेडिशंस, बिलीफ, वे ऑफ लाइफ. इट इज ऑल्सो राइट. So 1, 3, 4 is right. B answer will be there. ये क्वेश्चन तो बहुत इजी था. इट इज सो इजी. हमने इसको डिस्कस किया था, उस पॉइंट से हमने पूछा. इट मीन्स कि क्वेश्चन का वो आप जैसे जैसे आगे जाओगे क्लासेस में, नेक्स्ट टाइम से 1.5 आवर की क्लास होगी और बढ़ाऊंगा क्लास अभी. लेकिन आपको क्वेश्चंस जो है वो बहुत पूछे जाएंगे. इस तरीके से बहुत क्वेश्चन पूछे जाएंगे. तो चलिए जो है वो तो इस तरीके से क्वेश्चंस आपके होंगे. और चलिए इसी के साथ आज क्लास को एंड करने का समय आ गया है. सभी को वो नियमित बनाए रखिए. दिव्या जी बहुत जरूरी है कि नियमितता बहुत जरूरी है. नियमित रूप से जब क्लासेज ऑर्गेनाइज हो रही हैं तो सबको ज्वाइन करिए. चलिए. चलिए मैं इसी के साथ एंड करता हूँ, कल हम लोग फिर 6 बजे कल हम लोग फिर मिलते हैं।